I do admit that when I got to the south side, I was a little bit disappointed. I thought that, you know, that I would be hanging out with John Safran and great Jewish philosophers. And I was disappointed, actually, that Carlisle Street is very similar to Sydney Road. Basically, it's full of bearded men in tarragos with five kids in the back. I went to Glick's and I had terrible customer service, and I thought firstly they were maybe being Islamophobic, but then I realised they treat everyone like that. So now the reality is, if I wanted to live on a street full of tarragos and poor customer service, I would have stayed on Sydney Road. Now, so for me, that experience was very much like go back to where you came from. I was sort of like this Muslim in a new land, realising that we're really all the same. But like Justine pointed out, the beach is the decider. And Justine, this is my beach body, okay? Now, the reality is, what do they have in the north? Well, they've got Coburg Lake. Now, that wasn't even a punchline, but there we go. That's right. All you have is Coburg Lake. Do you ever see Coburg Lake in Melbourne's tourism videos? No, you don't. They've also got Greenvale Reservoir. They did have Pipeworks, if anyone's ever heard of Pipeworks. Pipeworks was great. It actually had Melbourne's only bungee jump. And when I Googled it, I typed in Pipeworks, bungee jump, and the autocorrect said deaths. Now, I've never actually heard of anyone dying there, but I guess when you put a bungee jump in the north, that's what people assume. They've actually shut it down. So Pipeworks shut down recently, and they're replacing it with an IKEA. So now the north has two IKEAs, and we have the beach. So congratulations on that. It's very exciting. Now, when I moved to the south, my parents didn't approve. They thought it would be hard to practice as a Muslim in the south. They basically said, it's very hard. There's no mosques. There's no halal butchers. And I had to convince them. Basically, I'm moving to St Kilda, not Sodom and Gomorrah. Like, there are still places to pray. It's still okay. And I did face some racism when I was there. People say, is it hard being a Muslim on the south side? And I applied for a job, and I wanted to work locally. And when I got in there, and they said, "Oh, what's your name?" I said, "Oh, it's Muhammad." They went, "Oh, actually, maybe we won't continue." I said, "Oh, that's a bit racist, don't you think? How dare you? As soon as you hear my name, you discriminate against me. That is discrimination." They went, "Yeah, no, it's not that we're racist. It's just we don't think you're qualified to be the chief rabbi at our synagogue." Thank you very much.
Greek, Italian, Chinese, Korean, Middle Eastern, Japanese, Somalian, Ethiopian. That's just our Uber drivers. Which we breed to give the South Side more diversity. Anything you want, any food you can get on the North Side. Actually, let's talk about our cafes and restaurants. Our diversity and inclusiveness in our lattes alone proves we're more progressive, interesting, and make a better place to live. We have coconut, almond, soy milk, decaf lattes. We even have chai lattes, matcha lattes, but we go beyond that. We have beetroot, turmeric, and mushroom lattes on the north side. Live your life on the south side, that's fine. Come and experience the fast lane of progressive Mother Nature and all she has to offer in a latte cup in the north. On the north side, we don't go to IKEA to buy jars to serve skinny milk out of. We were repurposing our jars from 5 years ago from the nonnas, the yeehaws, the nannies, the grannies, the picklers, and the Sunday market hipsters and raspberry jam makers. We've got muscle gyms and boxing rings and yoga studios. Our yoga is so inclusive. We've got Anshanta, Vinyasa, Hatha yoga, Bikram yoga. And I believe Fatram yoga is even being introduced in Brunswick. It's a tailor-made session for men so they can fart loudly while doing yoga.
My Semitic brothers and sisters, welcome. And interesting you should mention Trump. I had a dream about Trump last night, an actual dream. And in the dream, there was a headline that said, "Trump dead, condition described as satisfactory." The North Side is better than the South Side is one of the most preposterous propositions I have ever heard in my life. Now, tonight, I'm going to attempt to break stereotypes by really enhancing them. It could go badly. In the words of the late, great Jim Crochet, on the south side of the Yarra is the baddest part of town, and if you go down there, you better just beware of a Yid named Yossie Brown. Of course, the Jews used to own the north. Melbourne, or Carlton, was the original shtetl of the Jews in Melbourne. But then they had to move to the south because in the summer, humidity in the north was making the women's hair go too frizzy. You can't talk about the north versus the south without bringing up beards. In the north, if you have a beard, you're either homeless or a hipster. And the only way you can tell them apart is that one sells the big issue and the other one thinks they are the big issue. At least if you see a beard on the south side, you know it belongs to a nice Hasidic man who grows it for religious reasons, not to be slave to eating food in cafes off wooden boards instead of plates. And that's right, as Louise brought up, in the south, we sit on actual chairs. Chairs. Not milk crates. Chairs. And we drink coffee in the south. Coffee, that's it, coffee. It's just coffee. It doesn't have to be a long vanilla mocha with almond milk and a hint of rat sack. Does it need to be that? And Glix, I won't have anything bad said about Glix. I love queuing in Glix because I get to read the notice board. And you have to ask, has there ever been an Israeli come to this country that wasn't honest, hardworking and reliable? And the woman who works in Glix, my favourite woman in Glix, has what I think is the special I've just gotten out of bed shaitel. Like, it's a shaitel and it's a mess, so she's working. So it works for her.
You could live in the south and have no idea anybody else exists, or you could live in the north and be as connected to community as you want to be. There's no hiding there, we're real and we're true. We're the hundreds and thousands on top of the white bread.
I'd like to begin by acknowledging the traditional owners of the CBD, the Jewish property developers who came here in the 60s.